Welcome to this channel. So in my last night's video, I proved to you that the disaster in the translations of General Chi Chi Kwan classic. This is something need to be stopped. Because for decades, as soon as people package it out like a Chinese scholar or Chinese expert, they making all kinds of disastrous translation. And that translation is causing confusion. As yesterday I shared in the Chi Chi Kwan's videos, the Chi Chi Kwan translations video, people is keeping guessing, oh, you might say this, oh, I might say this. This is deep. Whenever people get confused and have no idea what it is, then they say, oh, this is deep. And you know what it leads to? It leads to all kinds of nonsense, magical Chinese martial arts. So you can see it. First, you get somebody who don't know the thing, clueless on it, and then they do a translation, but because the packaging is so good, then the image is so good, it's like a Chinese scholar. It's like I need to wear a Chinese pajama and put all this bead and then sit like this to tell you, this is Chinese. As soon as they package like that, then everybody believe that, okay? And then even if I speak nonsense, people get confused and they say, oh, that's wisdom, that's Zen wisdom. Okay? And then you start to have everybody can have their interpretations, everybody can have their ways, and you create all kinds of magical nonsense. And there's traditional Chinese martial art today. And some even go even further. Some even say that or speculate that General Chi Chi Kwan practice is like Tai Chi. It's not like MMA, it's like Tai Chi. Because they believe so. Well, when you start with a nonsense, a clueless nonsense, how can you derive all those kind of stuff? This is what I say. General Chi Chi Kwan's classic is a military classic. It is not somebody sit at home sofa and have the creativity. Okay? And then you put in the term Tai Chi this, Tai Chi that. Tai Chi, those kind of essay is nonsense. Okay? So I tell you all this straight really hard. Anybody, if they want to really understand traditional Chinese martial art, they need to know this thing. They need to learn, study and learn, and really get it. Get the context, get the traditional Chinese martial art context, and understand the ancient Chinese language. The first is one need to study Wu Pian of Tang Sun Zhi, and then the classic of General Chi Chi Kwan, and then the Shaolin Short Strike classic. So one need to study Wu Pian, make sure one know every words what the heck it is, and then the General Chi Chi Kwan classic. And then the Shaolin Short Strike classic. These three things, they are linked. Even for they spread for hundreds of years, they are linking together. So you can verify whatever Chi Chi Kwan said with this, and whatever Chi Chi Kwan said with this. Okay? That is the standard. So this is the standard of traditional Chinese martial arts scholar. If you never study these three, forget about your scholar title. You don't have it, okay? Just simply cannot just study some Chinese language, Google the thing, and then or keeping Tai Chi this, Tai Chi that, and then thinking one is some kind of pioneer. So today is the February 28, 2021. This is the standard. If you want to talk about as an authority or pioneer in studying of traditional Chinese martial arts, it's time to get it straightened up. Because there are too many victims today. And with those kinds of translation, you face it. No way one can show anything to prove anything with Xu Xiaodong. Because it is living in hallucinations. Like make one great, oh, I'm so great, I know this Chinese, I study from this teacher, that teacher. Who cares? When it comes to Chinese language, Chinese culture, it doesn't matter which grandmaster. If you don't know these three, forget about it, okay? It is not I say so, it is the history will say so. You mark my words, okay? So, standard has to be setting up now. Or else, we are contributing to damaging traditional Chinese martial art culture. Because we have no idea what it is and keeping speculate, create confusion, and then you pat my back, I pat your back, and we all are grandmaster. And then we come up with all kinds of fantasy. That's traditional Chinese martial art. Well, it's not acceptable. Even if we don't talk about this martial virtue, we just talk about today's business, okay? Everything is business, like selling an iPad. You need to have the specifications, the standard, to sell a product. So one cannot go sell whatever the Chinese, traditional Chinese martial art products in one way, do not have the specs and quality like an iPad, and another way screwing the Chinese culture. And yet, people, majority, the mass people are honest, good, innocent people. They believe. As soon as they see this package, they believe. And they follow it. And they become victims. They don't even know. And of course, when thing comes up, they even will defend whoever fit them the confusions and the nonsense. So that is the sad part. That's the sad part of traditional Chinese martial art. And that is the sad part of the people who practice traditional Chinese martial arts.